You know the question has crossed your mind. What if you shift your car to park while you're driving? Well, question no more. Here's how that experiment would play out. Accidents happen, people do silly things, and it may be easier than you think to knock a vehicle into park while it's cruising down the highway. If you haven't accidentally done it yourself at some point, you've probably at least wondered what the consequences would be if you shifted from drive to park without waiting for the vehicle to stop first. Would you screech to a sudden stop? Would the car's transmission rip itself apart? Would it just be utter incomprehensible chaos?
Anybody catch a license plate?
Or would the results be a little more mundane than that? You might be surprised. Before we look at what happens at speed, here's how a park function works when it's used properly and the car is stationary before it is engaged. A car's park function isn't the same as a handbrake or emergency brake. Instead of applying friction to the wheels to keep the vehicle still, the park function will instead lock the transmission so the car can no longer roll. It does this via a mechanism in the transmission itself called a pawl. Notches are carved into the transmission's output, and these are what the pawl engages when it's activated. The park function is designed so it can be engaged even if the lever isn't perfectly lined up with gear, and it can also be disengaged while the car is parked on a hill thanks to a taper on the mechanism, allowing it to disengage even if the weight of the vehicle is resting on it. The park mechanism is a simple yet brilliant design. However, it does have its drawbacks. If extreme force is applied to the mechanism, it can be damaged. That's why tow truck drivers will make sure the car being towed is in neutral before hauling it off. If a car is left in park, a lot of damage could be done to the vehicle. So with that in mind, we can make a few guesses about what might happen if it engages at high speed. The transmission, or more likely just the pawl, may be destroyed. If the vehicle is rear-wheel drive, forcing the powertrain to stop immediately could also lock the back wheels, which may cause the vehicle to spin out. But the reality is a little more anticlimactic. Realistically, nothing extreme would happen. In a moving car, the pawl is actually designed not to engage until the vehicle slows to a certain speed. Multiple YouTubers have tested shifting into park while driving anywhere from 40 to 60 miles per hour, and nothing much happens. The car continues to move and it'll go back into drive afterward. What you will notice in all of these is a scratching sound coming from the transmission when the car is in park. That's the sound of the drive shaft knocking the mechanism back every time it attempts to engage, just like it's designed to do. Newer models, particularly those with button shifters, also have software fail-safes to prevent exactly this sort of thing from happening. Another vlogger tested it in a Lincoln MKZ and found that the car automatically shifted to neutral when he pressed the park button. All that said, this is definitely not something you should try. Even fail-safes fail, and the last thing you want is to be the unlucky one in a million who manages to engage the parking pawl at high speeds and actually cause something unexpected to happen. At the very least, it's extremely hard on that little locking piece, and a transmission rebuild or replacement is one of the most expensive, complex, and labor-intensive jobs a mechanic can perform on a vehicle. It's often cheaper to just scrap a car and buy a different vehicle than it is to replace a ruined transmission. So, to sum it up,
son, just don't.